When you are creating activities tags in Google Tag Manager, you'll definitely want to make sure that your data is counting correctly. One of the key things you can do is actually go into your advanced settings for your individual tags and see this tag firing options right here. And what that does is tell Google Tag Manager how often this tag is allowed to fire. By default, it goes to once per event. Now, let's say for instance we're using this Google Analytics event of client content download. Now, it totally makes sense if you're going to download multiple different content on the same page. You want this to fire every single time. But let's say this was filling out a form and or some other activity where you really only want to capture it once per person, like applying for a job, and they only really need to do it once on that page. You can actually switch this to once per page. And then if they do the same activity twice within that same page, it will only pick up one time with the unique time that they did it the first time. Now, there's a third option for a tag firing option, which is called unlimited. And really, this only applies if you're doing tag sequencing, and it'll even give you it might give you a warning here of tag sequencing. So now you have to say, okay, this fires after another tag, and you're basically just like, allowing it to fire at any time that other tag, maybe either before or after another tag fires. So that will help keep your data consistent, especially if you're running into issues where, say, your form, you're getting five or six submissions on Google Analytics, but actually in the back end, you're only seeing maybe three or four. This could be an issue that could address that. So don't forget to subscribe to our channel to learn more about Google Analytics, Google Tag Manager, and BigQuery, and how they can help your business.